Okay, let's go to our Jira and look what we did in current sprint.
Can everybody see my screen?
Yeah, and just delete
Yep.
that right tab, close that right tab, and choose only stories in filters. Okay, so this is the current situation. Our core story in this sprint about importer, we will show it on Motosem's computer because we still didn't merge it due to some reasons, but we are going to do that. I hope we will do it in until Monday. But for now, we've already showed the stories. But Nick, let's just do quick review of these stories on real server, so just to remember how we were.
Yeah, I hope that I can remember what all the stories were.
Well, I hope. I will give you the names and you just show them onto our server. So just like a brief review what we did.
I'm just waiting for the instance to spin up. Okay, here we go.
Okay, so first story which we completed was Orphan OSRA ID about Orphan OSRA ID format. So let's look at the IDs. Yeah.
So yeah, as I explained on Google Plus, we cannot actually do a sort of live demonstration because we cannot create orphans right now.
I can so
But
we do the importer demo. It will
yeah, yeah, Motosem. Just later we'll do it. Just go briefly into these stories. Yeah, so we consider it as done. We will show it after importer. But as you can see now, we have also numbers in accordance with requirements. Next was about date of birth validation for orphans. That not more than 22 years. Is it working
Right.
with importer too or not?
No, it doesn't have to. I can demonstrate it right now. So if we go to edit an orphan and we set the date of birth to, I don't know, 1944, and then try to update. You can see that it says orphan must be younger than 22 years old. And if we now change it to 1994, then the update goes ahead.
Okay, great. After that, we finish with story about add the sponsorship status to orphan. So,
Right.
can you show it?
You can actually see it right now here. There is orphan sponsorship status. Is shown here as unsponsored. If we go to, and this is Alberto. So if we go to sponsors, pick a sponsor, link to orphan, pick Alberto, and say sponsor this orphan. We can now go back to the orphan page, and you can see that the sponsorship status is sponsored, and the current sponsor is linked here, so we can go
Oh,
directly to the
great.
sponsor page.
And now you can add sponsorship, and it will be previously sponsored, right?
And now, yeah, if I go, let's say if we go to
Do it.
sponsor 6, and now we end the sponsorship, now we go to back to Alberto, we see that the status is previously sponsored.
Great. And next one was about disable new orphan action.
Yeah. So if we go to the orphans index page, you can see that there is no button to add a new orphan.
Okay. After that, country drop-down list, which is very useful. Let's look at that.
So for sponsors, I can either create a new sponsor or edit an existing one. If we go to edit, you can see that the country is here. Here's a hint, drop-down list, top countries are here, and then the rest are in the list. And we can just pick, let's say, Turkey.
Yeah, great. Okay, next one was about sponsor filter on gender. Let's look at it.
So if we go to sponsors, you can see in the filters here, there is a gender. We can pick male, select filter. And unfortunately, so gender right now is not displayed in the index view.
But why?
Because we have not been requested to show it. Mm-hmm. If this is something that OSRA finds useful, then by all means, we would be happy to add the field here for the gender.
It's gender of sponsor, right?
Of sponsor, yes. And the same for the, we can sort on the female.
It's in sponsor. I thought it's for orphans, no? Sponsor filter on gender.
Yeah.
Gender. Oh. Interesting. Tarek and Ranim, do I really need to filter sponsors by gender? It's quite strange.
Actually, it's for the just for statistics.
Ah, for statistics, okay.
Mm-hmm. I'm sorry, can you say it again?
Saying, does OSRA need a similar feature for orphans as well? Because they have gender there, but we don't have the same feature.
So for orphans right now, yeah, we have the same...
We have gender here.
Why don't I see it?
It is in the middle.
Yeah. We can't see it here.
Oh yeah, here. Mm-hmm.
Oh, in the filtering.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but it looks like that we need to make the same things for orphans.
Would that be useful to you? If
Arak,
if
Ranim.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Again, please.
So. Remember how, if we go back to the sponsors, mm-hmm. the filter on gender right now mm-hmm. is just a drop-down box, any male or female. But if mm-hmm. we go to orphans, this is the default that the application has generated. Gender is contains equals, etc., and then you have to type in, let's say, male. So the filter works that way.
Yeah, it's better if you can make it like the sponsor method.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I thought that the filters are unique for all lists, but it seems it's not.
No, we have to customize them for each individual display. Yeah.
So if you can take the same as orphans, same as sponsors, it would be better if you can.
Yeah, sure. Okay.
Okay. Nikita, write it somewhere, okay? Oh, right here you can create, yeah. Oh, what are you doing? Oh, okay, you can just create, click button, read.
Where?
On the top you can click create button.
Okay, you'll show me later, Paul.
Okay.
So... Orphan gender sort. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay. Let's go further. Next one was sponsor start date validation to allow future dates up to beginning of next month.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so we go to sponsors and we're entering a new sponsor. Just give it a quick name. Okay, so this is the start date. The default date is today, and previously the start date could be either today or any date in the past, but nothing in the future. Now we've changed it so that all dates up to the first day of the next month are valid. So I can select November 1st as the start date, and you see that it is created. Whereas if I were to choose November 6th, there is a validation problem here, so we need to go back to the first.
Okay, next story was about consistent data field order in new edit and show views, which we created.
This is a bit, I guess, tricky to demonstrate, but say looking at the sponsors here, for example, status, gender, start date, orphan count, request fulfilled. If we go to edit, status, gender, start date, orphan count, type, you can see request fulfilled. You can see that they're in the same order, and we've done the same for partners, and we've done the same for orphans. Mm-hmm. So the fields that you get in individual show view are the same that you get on the, in the same order that you get them on the edit field, in the edit view.
Okay. And the last one story, which we completed, not last one, but not shows sponsorship status and link to actively sponsoring sponsor, if any, on orphan page.
So yeah, I demoed that essentially. If we go, I showed it that when you create a sponsorship, the statuses show up here, and if an orphan is actively sponsored, so let's say if we take a sponsored orphan here, you can see that there's a link to the sponsor who is currently sponsoring this orphan. The difference between the two stories, for us at least, was that the first story was entirely behind the scenes. It wasn't about displaying the sponsorship status, it was just about setting it automatically when a sponsorship is created or terminated. The second story is about displaying it the way you see it here.
Now, we have one store which wasn't accepted yet, but we can show it right now, and we can accept it right now. It's about sponsors whose requests have been fulfilled shouldn't be eligible to form new sponsorship.
I don't think that's deployed yet, Paul.
Ah, really? Okay.
Yeah, because I was waiting for... I can try it, but I'm pretty sure I haven't deployed it yet. Because I am hoping to demo these two stories together. Yeah. So, Modusum has already finished this story. It's just... It has not been deployed yet, that when you change the request fulfilled to yes, this link to orphan button disappears. And I have completed the story, but it has not been reviewed yet, that this request fulfilled, you saw me just now, I changed it manually here. I've implemented a story where it's handled entirely by the application. Mm-hmm. So as sponsorships are added, for example, for this particular sponsor, once he or she is sponsoring four orphans, request fulfilled will be automatically set to yes. And when that happens, this link to orphan button disappears.
Mm-hmm. So, okay, for now it's not working. Okay, not on stage, sir. Okay, never mind. We still have some stories from this sprint in our code review. We are going to show them through our Google Plus until Monday, which is the end of our sprint. But for now, we want to show you the most important story in this sprint is about import orphans from an orphan list. So, Modusum, can you show it? And can you share the screen so we will see it on your screen?
Okay, can you guys see my browser?
Modasim, please speak a bit louder because we, at least I not hear you well.
How is it now? Can you guys hear me?
Yes, it's a bit, it's not very clear, but yeah.
Not clear.
Okay. So, can you see the screen?
Yes.
So now we have, from a sponsor page, we click on anyone sponsor, and of course they have to be active, for partners. Partners now. If a partner is active, I will see the upload orphan list button, and when I click that, I will be taken to this page. I can choose the file I want to upload. I will start first with a file containing three orphan details. When I click upload, it will take me to a page where it will, if the file is valid and all the details are passed the validation, I will see something like this, which lists the orphans that found in the Excel file. And here, the user can either import those or cancel, like if they want to change something on the file first. If they see something that's, for example, they need to work on in this file. If I click import, it will take me back. It will tell me that this is the orphan list ID has been imported successfully, and that three new orphans are now created in the system. I can go to orphans, and I can see the new orphans here with their new IDs. I will give you an example now where if we submit an invalid list, I choose I click upload to try to validate the orphans. It finds a lot of errors there, so it will list all of the errors in the file. This is the location in the sheet, so this is cell 4C, and this is the explanation of the orphan. So it says, for example, for this one, it's missing mandatory field. I don't know if you guys can read this clearly, but here, for example, mandatory fields are missing, it will flag them. If the option is not one of the values that you gave us, for example, for mother alive, the values are I think mutawaffa, mawjuda, or something. So, ala qayd al-haya is not a valid option, so it's flagged this as an error. Same things for provinces, for example. If the province is misspelled or given in a different way, that's not in accordance with the list of values that you gave us as valid. All of those will be flagged, and the user will be able to look at all the errors. And of course, we will not see the import button here. They have to go back and fix it and upload it again.
Is the Excel file contain many fields? I haven't seen it before.
You cannot. Okay. Let me share my. Open it. Basically, I have three files that I've been working with.
Mm-hmm.
And one of them contains one valid record, one contains three valid records, and one contains three invalid records with different... fields. This one,
I try. What are you doing now? You're trying to show a file. Okay.
Add my Excel file. Can you see the screen now?
Yep. Yep.
Now, I think I have an issue with displaying Arabic properly on my Excel version. So anyway, I think it's clear for the OSRA team what these means. So we have here, this is an example of a file with only one valid record. His name, father's name, father is martyr, these are optional details, this is date of death. And similarly, I have another file with three valid orphans with different values.
Mm-hmm.
And another file with three invalid orphans with the, I can show that as well. For example, I'm missing some mandatory fields. I have some
okay. Well, after deploying this importer to our stage and server and accepting it, actually, you should be able to work with our system. Motosam, are we ready to deploy it to production? Who will release after we will finish with story?
It has not been merged yet on the code repository. So maybe this is, I need to discuss with Nikita, like if everything is okay, we can just merge it, and then we can deploy it on the staging. We were thinking of doing some refactoring on the way it is implemented, but maybe we can do that as a separate story,
Not story, definitely, it's a chore, but we... Basically, we need to decide, are we going to start working with that functionality of OSRA in production, or we need Sprint 5 to complete some other not important stories in the refactor of this one.
For this, I have to say something. One thing that OSRA team sent me a new version of the Excel file. So there are some changes on the format. I think there is one additional field.
Yeah.
So we need one story to address that. I did not work on this because I wanted just the first version I've been working on the current format to be accepted first. Then I can add one more story. It's not a major change. It's just a simple story of. You see that the way we define the different fields in the Excel file is just in a configuration file, so I just have to add one row to that configuration file and test it, of course. So there is one more story that we need to do to make the importer, I think, production ready for OSRA.
Mm-hmm. Tarek, Ranim, are you ready to go into production with that functionality?
I think this was the most important thing that we need. If we can use it at this stage, then I will be thankful. If we can use the production right now.
I think the question is, if we get you this functionality in production, would you start using it with real data, with real lists? And
yes. I think yes. I don't know what do you think, Tarek?
Yeah, these are the basic requirements for the program, and we can use them now.
Okay, great. The second question: we need to decide which functionality we should take for the new sprint, like for new release. After this importer would be finished and some stories in our backlog for phase zero will be merged, it's not that much work. We need to decide on what our goal would be for the next sprint and for the next release. Actually, traditionally we have two options here. First option is to not to make any development after before you will work for some time with a program and understand what you really need. The second option, if you already knows what we need to do, we just start to work on second release and improve step by step your functionality. We have backlog now. Nikita, can you show our backlog?
Yeah, just a second. I'll reshare my screen.
Yeah, open our backlog. Yeah, backlog. Yeah. And what do we?
Sorry.
It is a backlog.
This is the backlog. Yeah.
Ah, this is the backlog. Okay. Display created, added, and modified, and show views, navigation. Main store is like navigation, menu, display. What is it about?
This is related to when we go into the list of orphan lists belonging to a partner, the navigation on the top changes because this is a nested resource, and they wanted like the navigation to be consistent across all pages.
Okay, let's go far. It's not that not the core story for sprint for release. Save and create another, it's the same. Email format validation, the same. Sure. Name should not allow special characters. Let's go far for now. Adult or yeah?
I'm saying that for the next release, I mean, if we were looking for something major, maybe the things related to orphan card, PDF generator.
Maybe. Let's just go for backlog and see what else. Sponsored data shouldn't allow data priority orphan establishment. Oh, it's already done. Adult orphan display, what is it?
Which one? Number?
One, two, six. Who above 18 years old? The roles of such orphans to be highlighted. Oh, okay, let's go far. Upload images for orphan and related official docs. This is, I think, important.
Maybe. I mean, what do you need to tell us?
We can manage a photo and other scan doc for orphans. Well, Tarek, Ranim, can you describe, this is important with Excel or importer separately for each orphan?
No, the way you explained it to me is that this is a separate upload page where you can upload one or probably, if possible, multiple either images or PDFs. And based on the file name format of those files, those will be saved and then linked to the proper fields in the orphan. So based on the file format, the importer will know this, that this is a personal photo of this orphan ID, so it will link to somehow to that orphan. If this is a family book of this orphan. The subtext is important.
No, so there is one main photo for the orphan. Mm. This will be used in the orphan card.
Yes.
If there are more photos, maybe it will be in his folder with his official documents.
Mm.
Right.
Yes, but if you remember, we said that if the file name is the ID of the orphan, the OSRA number of the orphan, .jpg, for example, that is the personal photo.
This is the personal photo which will be used in our system.
Yes. Mm. And you probably want it to be displayed on the orphan page and maybe later generated in the PDF.
Right, on the orphan card.
The ID -1, it means family book. -2 means something else. So.
Right, I do remember.
Yeah, but this is not This is not related to the Excel importer. This is the
So what do you think, Tarek, about this functionality? Is this important for next release, or it's something that you may
for
probably
the first
not
release, you mean?
For the next release.
Next is the second one or the first?
Yes.
So for phase one.
For phase one. Yeah, for phase one.
For phase one, yes. For phase zero, it's not required now.
Yeah. For phase one, okay.
We have to go live. Okay. The phase one, yes, because we prefer to issue or to generate the orphan card automatically.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Let's go far. Next story about users. Add the user. What is it about? So that we can have more people helping the team and to build to add new users. The application admin role, new users, usernames should be unique. Users will have roles. Okay, users, roles, and passwords. Eric, what do you think about it as a first phase, or it can be done later?
Again, please.
That story is about user management. Is this very important as a next step, or it may be important later, not as a next step?
You mean the role? The role.
Yeah, role functionality, role users, yeah.
If it can be done by the administrator, it's okay.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And then let's do it later. Okay, passwords the same. Orphan card display. As an orphan manager, so that I can see a summary about an orphan, I need a read-only view of a subset of orphan details. Okay, this one I think is phase one. Just click L. Yeah. Oh. Yeah. Phase one. Okay. Orphan card PDF generation. Orphan card PDF generation.
Okay, I think if you have the card displayed in the same field that we displayed, it will just be generated in a PDF.
I don't know. Let's look at it. We need to print it, or why we need to? Summary card about orphan need to be able to generate a PDF file. For what purposes we are doing PDF files, Tarek?
Because we send this PDF file to the sponsor.
Mm-hmm.
We print it on PDF or on paper to send it as a document to the sponsor.
It's with photo, right? With all this stuff.
Yeah.
Okay. Then that's phase one, definitely. Mm. Yeah. Phase one. It's already in phase one.
Yep.
And orphan English orphan card PDF generation, I think the same.
Yes.
Already phase one, okay. What is it? I18N? What is it?
Internationalization.
Internationalization.
Make the front end Arabic English, like you can switch between the different languages for the interface.
Oh, cool. I think it's not a story, it's epic. Let's go for it. Let's look. It's about changing the interface language.
Yeah, like you would have a button at the top saying English or Arabic, and you can switch between these two languages.
Uh-huh. So we need to create two labels in two languages and many, many stuff, right?
Yeah, I mean, the translation of the actual labels, this is maybe separate stories, but the actual implementation of this functionality to switch around to left to right and to right to left, read from this resource bundle,
mm-hmm.
This is the story, and then the translation of the labels is a set of different stories that we have to add as we go along.
And for now we have English.
Yeah, now everything. I mean, currently it's not being read from an internationalized list of fields.
Uh-huh.
So we need to change that to make it read it from an internationalization document or set of labels, and then we need to add those labels. And we can default back to English if something is not already translated.
Mm-hmm.
But this is not phase one even, right?
Phase two, last phase.
Last phase. Phase maybe end. Not last. Okay,
there's no last phase, is there?
No last phase. Phase two, okay. And basically that's it, what we have in our backlog. So, our goal for the next release would be that orphan card PDF and some small stories that makes your life easier.
Is there anything major, Tarek, that's missing from phase one, for example, that you would like to have in phase one?
No, actually, phase one or phase zero, you mean?
Phase one.
User roles are now in phase one, right?
No, in phase two.
Phase two?
Yeah.
Is it too far?
I don't know if it's too far or not. We may be do it. It's just next priority. After we can decide to do it in phase one. We can decide to do it in phase two. Uh-huh. Actually, I think we will update the program every sprint. We shouldn't wait. So our phase is actually abstract thing, not real thing after phase zero.
Okay.
So it's just about priority. The first priority is card. After card, we can do user management, or we can do, for example, internationalization. For now, it's user management after cards. After user management, it's internationalization. That's it.
Okay.
So you consider uploading the photos as part of the card epic?
Yes, and we need to standardize our photos because we have multiple sizes and multiple photos, so we have to standardize them. I think this process will take a long time because we have a big quantity of the photos. So can we have a timeline for that?
Your team members will have to do this, or you want the application to?
No, we will do them because this we have the photos, but they are not on the same size or the same extension. Mm-hmm. So we have to standardize them.
Mm-hmm.
This might not be something that you have to do. Modusum, we're using paperclip, right?
Yeah.
So one of the libraries that we're using to manage uploads, it can handle, we can predefine what size images it puts, let's say, in it. If we're talking about the orphan card, we can tell it what size image to put into that card. It will automatically resize whatever image you give it. And it can work with JPEG, GIF, PNG, the common formats, basically.
Formats.
So this may not be something that you have to do at all.
Okay, that sounds good.
Okay, so after we will finish that functionality, you just try to upload different sizes of images and we'll see. But I think, yes, there are many programs that can resize.
Okay, so just for me to clear this up, user management, is this phase one priority?
Let's do it. You know, there shouldn't be phase one, phase two now, because we have backlog, we have top items on the backlog, we have later items on the backlog. As I understand, first priority cards. Second priority, user management. Third priority, internationalization.
Nikita, Raneem just posted on the Google Plus post, which contains something related to the users, because we want to add a field in the sponsors page, which referred to the agent. Who is the agent? The agent is the OSRA team member. Who will follow follow up with the sponsor to get the monthly sponsorship from him and these matters. So This agent will be one of the users. If you can refer to...
So we need to have the users implement. We need to have be able to add users before we can add this functionality.
We should have the users, but not necessarily the role.
Yeah, it's on the first point of Ranim's post.
Yeah, I see that. Okay.
It's not something related to the role of the users, but at least to that we should have the users.
Okay, so that sounds to me like users are a priority then.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's do it in phase one then.
Actually, adding the users functionality is not that important. If you could add the users, if the admin could add the users, it could work because we have a limited number of OSRA team members.
Okay. Do you mean in a sense that if we, the developer team, could add those users to the application?
No. For example, currently, if you go to the staging server, you can see there is a tab or a link at the top for admin users.
Yeah.
And you can add a user there.
Maybe in this phase we just add the users, without putting the roles or something. Mm. Just put the users to use them in the agent.
Maybe you guys can test this functionality and see if it fits exactly your requirements, or for example you need to change it somehow. Because maybe for example you have a requirement to say this user is in this city, or this is the real name for the user. So I'm not sure exactly if... just test it out and let us know.
Yeah, so this is available right now on the staging server. So please give us feedback on whether it's sufficient for you or we need to do something else.
Ranim, Tarek?
Yeah.
Okay.
Actually, I hope you could read what Ranim wrote before. Because it requires adding a field to the sponsor page.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And this field is the person who's following up with this particular sponsor.
Okay, so it's one of the users.
Yes, so if we created a user for each OSRA member, this user is going to be linked to one of those users are going to be linked to the sponsors.
Okay. Can I ask actually before we go through all these points, all this, is this phase zero, phase one? How do you want us to treat all these new stories?
Actually, we prefer this to be in phase zero. I know it's too late to mention it now, but we just got the point now.
Okay. It's not too late in the sense that we can. But phase zero can take as much time as necessary, but you just won't get to use the application.
Because when you use the application and when you try it and test it, you will have too much points to be mentioned.
Right. You know? Okay.
So without this, you can't use the application, or you can?
We can use it, but something major will be missed.
So you see, so if you see this as phase zero, then we're definitely looking at least sprint five.
But we can, as I understand, if we deliver this functionality about Excel importer, we can make it in a production, and also a team can start working with it in production. And this time we will do sprint five with this functionality for users and deliver it in next 2 weeks. That it may be better than not to use application.
I'm just worried about one thing, that if they start using it in production and start entering real data, and then some of those stories, because I'm looking quickly, scanning through the requirements, seems they are asking for new fields in the tables. So maybe that will, if we already have data in production, those will be affected, and then we'll get into the inconsistent.
Okay. Nick, this is why
I'm thinking that you should read those stories before deciding if it's phase zero or one. Mm-hmm. It affects how the database works.
Phase zero, phase one, I think it's more. I always thought of it as your decision, basically. If we deliver the importer functionality and you can actually start using the application, then we consider that phase zero complete, and everything else that we add after that is phase one, phase two, etc. But if all these new stories would prevent you from actively using the application, then they become phase zero.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're saying, if I understood correctly, you're saying that you would be reluctant, or it would be difficult for you to use the application if these new stories were not implemented.
Okay, just one question. Once we start to use the program, mm-hmm. we will enter all our database in it, and we will start relying on it, right? We will not be going back to the Excel sheets we are using now.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So once the phase zero is finished, we are on the program, right?
You are live.
Well, ideally, I would say yes. I wouldn't blame you if you want to, be careful and use them maybe in parallel for just a little bit to make sure that, you're not missing major bits of functionality from our application.
Because you see here, there are some fields to be added. So if we added those fields later, those fields later, we will have to go through all the process one more time, and we will have to go one by one for all the sponsors and add those fields.
We will have some problems with migration, maybe not manually, but automatically, but it definitely may be huge problems to do. And that's Motosim point is very important in this case. If there are many fields in this wave, it's maybe better to wait until they will be realized in the system.
Okay, that sounds logical to me. So let's say that these are all phase zero and that we don't deploy the application until the end of next sprint.
Yeah, I think yes. For next 2 weeks, a goal for OSRA team would be to test importer of Excel file as much as you can, because that's the core story, and I think in real testing of just import big lists with orphans and try to see how it works. So it won't be confusing later, because this is very important functionality. And we will do next 2 weeks. We will try to do all these stories for phase zero. Yeah.
Okay. Sounds like a plan.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, Ranim, Tarek, do you want to say anything else in addition?
Thank you so much. Appreciate your work. Ranim, do you have anything?
No, thank you.
So for those new points, do you guys have something to say about them now, or later we'll pick it up on the Google community page, and for each one we will have a post explaining the exact requirement and adding it as a story?
Okay. That would be fine.
Okay.
Martinson, before I go, I have a question for you. When you showed us the errors of the file of the Excel sheet,
yes,
is these errors are how can we get them out of the program of the application? Because these errors are shown on the page, right, on the application, when you step back to another page, they will disappear, right?
Currently, yes. Is there, as a requirement, you can say, for example, that you want to download them, maybe, or
yeah, to work on them, or take a report of them, a report or something. I don't know.
Then definitely, this is a new, like a, something new that I have to add, because currently it just displays them on the page. Yes.
Because as you saw, there are too many errors.
Yes, we have some.
You cannot work on them in the same time.
Yes. So you guys can see my screen.
Yeah.
Yes. So for example, this is the list. You want something like here, like a new button that says maybe export this list.
But you can just copy it. Why not?
Yes.
What's the purpose? Why can't you just copy?
Yes.
What doesn't try to copy it?
I'll copy it as in like.
Yeah.
Copy to Word or Excel?
Yeah.
This is one option. Yes.
Okay, fine.
You really don't need the importer functionality here. At least you can do easily without it.
Well, for the time being, I understand that it would be nice to get a formatted report out of this, and this is something that we can do in the future. But I think for the time being, if you just print the page, basically you
will open another tab, work on, leave this open.
Okay, fine.
Or just take.
Or we can copy them.
Okay.
But would you like me to add a story for exporting this somehow in the future, or what do you think? You work with it, and you see if you still need it.
For the future.
Okay.
Okay, for the future, for the far future, but okay. For now it's okay.
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 Okay. Okay, then. Let's call it a day. We'll discuss these stories later. Guys, Brian, Motosem, Nick, can you, Alex, can you stay here for a while?
Not sure.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Tarek.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Okay. Thank you.
Bye bye. Okay, guys. About these stories, can we add them to Jira, or who will add them?
I'll do it.
Are they clear? Like, do we understand exactly?
Let's go through it quickly and let's see if we understand them or not.
If we further them, then we can discuss it.
An agile field. Let's also remember who should follow the sponsored contact here. This field should be joined to the users. I cannot understand that. It's connected to the users, should be, or what?
Yeah, so it's
the new column or new field attribute for this. Is it the sponsor?
Yeah, but this is more complicated than it looks, because first we need to create an association between users and sponsors.
Yeah.
And then in this field we enter the
agentship.
The agent, yeah, the OSRA user who is responsible for this sponsor. So it's not just an extra field in the view, it's an association at the database level.
Yes, because we can have many users, right? To
yeah.
One sponsor association. Okay, yeah, it's quite a big story. Okay, next. Yeah.
I mean, are we clear on? Even if it's difficult to do, but at least are we clear on what is the requirement? Then we can add it here. If not, we can discuss with the OSRA team to clarify it more for us.
I think it's clear.
This one is clear. Yes.
Okay.
A city field represents the city where the sponsor lives. Mandatory. But we don't have city now, right?
I don't think so, but let me have a look. So this is sponsors, right?
Yeah.
No. Well, we have an address, but it's kind of a free form. You can put anything you like in there.
Okay, city. But cities should be mandatory. And again, cities preferred to be drop-down list with the most famous cities in each existed country. Oh, my gosh.
Does that mean the largest cities from the top countries that are on the country list?
I'm not sure. Maybe, like, for example, for all countries, like, based on the country drop-down, we populate another drop-down with the most famous cities.
But let's say capital
cities, because most famous is loose definition.
Yeah, I understand that. But anyway,
most famous cities.
You have to have other there.
Yeah.
Yes, but not. But capitals is just one city for each country. But we should have. Oh my gosh! Where should we take this information?
Is that available in a gem autosim or no?
The gem I used had very interesting data, but I mean specifically about the United States, it has a lot of things. But about other countries, I'm not sure. And maybe it had a capital for every single country. That's the one I used. I don't know if other gems are there that have these.
Yeah. But, you know, this sounds to me like maybe they haven't quite thought it through. I mean, a drop-down list of countries, there's, what, 200-somewhat countries. But a drop-down list of cities, how many cities are it in the world?
Not in the world, in the country. It's not that much.
That would be just a list for that country.
Also, okay, I got you. So once you populate the country first, and then you get a drop-down list of cities. Oof. Okay.
We just need to understand where to take this drop-down list of cities. I think we can find some information.
We can look for it. Another approach would be to ask them, like, for example, the number of sponsors they work for is not that huge, so we can say, like, give us a list of those sponsors come from which cities. So the list maybe, I don't know, 15, 20, 25 cities only.
Yeah, we can ask them for Excel file with all sponsors and just make some statistical analysis. Just write all cities and that's it.
And then later, for example, once they have new sponsors from different cities, either they will tell us at the city or maybe that's where the other field will come in play.
Yeah.
And then that will be added to the drop-down list, so next sponsor from the same city will be able to choose.
I just see one problem with drop-down list. You cannot just add new values there, right?
Well, you can if we actually persist the cities to the database, if we have a separate model.
And then on the next refresh of the page, that will show on as a drop-down option.
Oh, okay. Next one, additional information field for any further information. That's quite it's easy one.
We have it.
We have it. Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's right there.
Additional. Yeah, we have it. Great.
Go here. Just.
Okay. Yeah. It's okay. Yeah. We have it. Let's go for. Payment plan. Tell us if it's possible. We'll pay monthly, every 2, 4, 6 months, or annual, and also other choice. It's the drop down list, as I understand.
Yeah, drop down list.
It's easy one. Okay. I need to be able to enter sponsorship start date and sponsorship end date. Whenever I link an orphan with a sponsor or end any sponsorship, those were the new things. Thankfully, I've added. Oof. My gosh.
Nick, do we track end date for the sponsorship when we break the link?
Well, what it does at the moment, let me show you. It basically, what it records right now simply is the updated at. So the last update of the sponsorship, which, you know, in the model, or sorry, in the application, there isn't anything else that you can do with sponsorships other than create them and terminate them.
Yeah, but you can sponsorship the same orphan again, and that would change that.
No, actually, it gets added as a new sponsorship.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Yeah.
So here you can just plan sponsorship, like not to start it right now, but start it a month or 2 months later, right? And you want to make a sponsor for 1 year, for example, and you will add sponsorship end date right when you creating it. Oh my gosh!
And you want it presumably to end automatically.
I don't know. Maybe.
That's.
It's something we need to discuss. It's something really hard. I will link an orphan with a sponsor. No, whenever I link an orphan, I need to be able to enter a sponsorship start date and end date. Or end any sponsorship. Quite strange.
We need to clarify this with them more.
Yeah, I don't know. For some reason, I suspect that they want sponsorships to end automatically.
Yeah, maybe. Okay, let's discuss that. Next things, if you get a sponsor for an organization, its type should be organization. And the organization name shouldn't be empty. And the branch name shouldn't be null.
That's exactly how it is right now.
Okay.
So if we go to sponsor, for example, new sponsor. What does it say again? It's
for
type.
Organization. Its type should be organization. Okay.
Sorry here. Oh, so they want automatically, once you choose organization from here, then...
That validates that organization field is not empty.
And right. So, yeah, you cannot have individual and organization. Okay, gotcha.
If you leave it empty now, it will not give you... if you fill the branch only now, it will...
Yeah, you can do that.
Okay.
Yeah. We don't want this.
Uh-huh, okay.
Okay.
This is something that Ahmed mentioned a while ago, that this type, they don't need it anymore. They want to take it off altogether.
Well, yeah, this is something that I'm still not clear on. We have two stories in Jira right now that are flagged because of this.
Mm.
In fact, now that you mentioned it, I realize that, of course, we should have talked about it because I still don't understand what they want.
Mm-hmm.
Again,
if we get him here for OSRA, its type should be individual. Second one was same.
Okay, so, yeah. It's basically... First, you set this field, and that automatically determines which one of these two fields you can set. Okay.
And
so
last
we're talking about JavaScript here, then, right?
I think she means just the validation. Like now, I can choose organization and the brand. Save it. It will save.
Okay. Well, yeah. If it's validation, it's simple.
Yeah, but I'll clarify this with them further because I remember Ahmed said something a little bit contradictory to this, so I'll discuss with them.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And last one, I shouldn't be able to change the sponsor type from organization to branch and vice versa.
Okay, well, that's doable.
Okay. Wow. You need to add them.
So the ones. Okay, we need a clarification on the city. Is that right?
Yes.
The end date.
Yeah.
And I guess this whole thing.
Yeah, the 2 points about.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. So, Morosem, you'll ask him for clarifications on these?
Yes. Would you ask add a task for me so that I just don't forget and keep track, and then I can update that with their answer?
Yep. Okay, so I'll put these all into Jira, and we'll keep notes in there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, guys, when are we going to have a retrospective?
Monday, I presume. Hopefully, Craig will be back.
What or so what? You cannot participate on Monday, right?
I mean, I can maybe for an hour during my lunch break, but that's like even nothing during like the time that I actually lunch time. If we can meet earlier, I can. Like now, it is almost 4. So for me, it would be like 3 hours earlier, or 3 to 4 hours earlier than now, would be my lunch time. So I can have an hour break or so.
3 hours.
So it would be 1600 UTC.
1600 UTC.
Yes.
Oh my gosh.
It's too bad that Craig's away because we could try to do it tomorrow otherwise.
Mm-hmm. We can ask Craig. Maybe he will join. Maybe he will be able tomorrow.
Okay.
Because I think that some things like planning and retrospectives and client meetings we should do now on weekends.
Yeah.
And I'm okay with weekends.
So it would be again something like 1830, 1900 UTC on the weekend?
Tomorrow.
Yes, if tomorrow, Motasan, whatever.
The day we started at 1830. Tomorrow at 19 UTC, I have something. So up to that, I'm okay.
Okay.
Ah. Okay, at 18 UTC. And you can at 18 UTC, right, Nick?
18 itself is a bad time. I can do maybe 2 hours earlier or 19, but 18 itself is bad. Mm-hmm. How about I just ask him this? If he's available tomorrow at all.
Okay, ask him. We'll see. If not, well, then on Monday, after OSRA Scrum, without Motorsam, or if Motorsam can join us for 15 minutes, maybe, I don't know. But Motorsam, even if you cannot participate, just write some your thoughts about we did and what went well, what can we improve, something like that, so we can discuss it, and at least you will look, you will watch this video later. And
yes,
so, Pavel, you're telling me that I could have clicked this button here to create a story? Yeah, okay. Anything else?
We did not hear anything from Brian or Alex.
Yeah. Well, Brian and I talked about before about what he's working on, and Alex, how's your schedule? Are you getting ready to join us?
Yeah, I am. I'll probably see what time the retrospective will be done, and thereafter I'll try to probably pick a simple story to try and get my feet wet as well.
Sounds good. I think we have a few stories that would be easy to get into. Anything else we need to talk about, guys?
that?
No.
Pavel, are you there still? Did we lose him?
The Pavel is down.
Now? Oh, oh my gosh. Something happens with my microphone.
So, is there anything else to talk about? No. Can you hear us now?
Why? Nick?
Now we can.
Do you hear me?
Yes, yes.
Yes.
Wait a second, please. Now it's okay. Now I hear you.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay, guys. Thank you. See you tomorrow on Monday.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Everybody have a good rest of your weekend.
Yeah. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye.